Without wasting too much time, you know, because the speaker next has a flight to catch to go back to Delhi, is a talk on importance of surface material to help control hospital-acquired infections. And to give a talk would be Mr. Herdev Singh, healthcare segment leader from DuPont Protection Solutions. He has an extensive experience of more than a decade in sales and technology consulting in healthcare, interiors, building materials, oil and natural gas. Prior to joining DuPont, he worked at TriStar, Suvira Group and ISP, where he has held senior management positions across sales and marketing. Herdev is a postgraduate from University of Petroleum and Energy Studies, Dehradun, and graduate in civil engineering from Kashmir University. His area of interest includes trends in healthcare industry and healthcare materials. Please welcome Herdev Singh.
I'm Herdev, and I work with DuPont and look at the segment for the healthcare in which we have this material called Corian. I think almost all the architects, doctors are aware about this material. I'll just share our experience, how you can help, how this material can help you control infection in the healthcare infrastructure, which is the hospitals and all. So what is healthcare acquired infections? I would say, you know, whenever a patient comes in contact with any kind of a viral pathogen, fungi, which he hasn't, you know, brought into the hospital, but having acquired it from the hospital infra, that is hospital acquired infections. These are the settings, unfortunately, where a patient comes to heal, but you know, these are some things that he can, you know, either prolongs the stay of the patient in the hospital, or you know, he gets more complexities because of that. How big is the issue? I would say, you know, if we see globally, the trend says that 7 to 12% hospital acquired infections. When we talk about even the Western countries, we say it's okay on the marginal side, it's around 1%, but goes to a high of 8%. Of course, 3 patients discharge out of 100 in USA and all get this infection, which is serious. And in India, we say 10 to 30% is the infection rate. And in some of the best hospitals also, they say around 3% is what is established. And this is what has been reported. I mean, because of the NAV accreditations and all other things. What has not been reported, we can't tell here or discuss here. In terms of the, you know, I'll just thought, you know, because we talked about the percentages, maybe it made sense, maybe it didn't make sense. I thought I'll just put in almost USD 33 billion is spent every year for this hospital acquired infections. 1 in 10 die out of this infection. It's as big as this issue, which says, you know, even if a jumbo jet crashes every day, it will not kill more as compared to what a hospital acquired infection can do. So that is the seriousness of this issue. And yes, we at DuPont are trying to do something on our own, but of course it has to be a collective, because you know, we have a surfacing solution, but there are other ways through which this infection spreads. This is through contact, airborne, and water. We talk about how we reduce it is, you know, reduce contamination, which means how you segregate it, how you demarcate, how you take the waste disposal and all, prevent transmission, you know, how you have the areas which are, you know, kept as isolated areas, stuff like that. And of course, influence behavior. It says that, you know, even a study says that the washing of hands reduces the hospital acquired infections by almost like 30%. So which means there are behavioral changes that you can take care of, which will help reduce the contact, contamination and all. When we are talking about how the industry has evolved, you know, I'd seen with how the OTs and all other things, they operated. Initially, it was like a operation theater. Theater would mean actually a theater. No thought around the infection control or this. People would stand there, witness how it was being acquired. There would be just curtains and all, and then things started changing, you know, using from the tiles to the stainless steel or any other material, PVC linings and all, glass and stuff like that. But of course, these materials do have certain issues, which is there is porosity, there is a weatherability. That means over a period of time, it would, you know, deteriorate. There is a repairability issue, you know, in case if something happens wrong, the whole thing needs to be changed, yeah. So, and then there is, so which means there is maintenance cost is high, the durability is not there. So we propose at DuPont, you know, we had this material called Korean. And before I run into what this material is, I would just share this small. Some people would have seen it, but excuse me for that. Can we have the volume, please?
Dev is at school. I have been watching on Facebook.
When designing the Ancient Valor Institute, we tasked architects for two critical things. One, to create a safe space. And the second was to create a space that was really uplifting, life-affirming, that would improve emotional and physical well-being for our young adults.
When you come in here, it was colorful and kind of a teen mood going on. It just made you feel happy when you work.
Teens, when they come into the space, are often in a place of emotional darkness. So we use the idea of light as a counterpoint. The more ambient light that you can incorporate, the better the mood, the emotional well-being of the patients who are going through that space. We never conceived of this space as a sterile clinical environment. We always thought of it as more of a boutique hotel. DuPont Corian became the backbone of the project. We're using it extensively throughout.
Corian is a remarkable material and is suitable for the healthcare environment. It is not porous, and it doesn't promote the growth of bacteria. I think it has a calming and healing effect. When you use materials that allow light to pass through and to warm the environment.
I don't know that you could ever come to a place and be told you had a diagnosis of cancer and expect to have an uplifting experience. I think we've created an environment that permits that.
When I found out that I was cancer-free, are you okay? Of course I went and I had to make a status on Facebook. Now that I'm a survivor, you can't stop me now.
So of course, the story remains. This is very emotional, in terms of what all a cancer patient would go through, And, as a responsible, I would say, the people who create these kind of infrastructures, they understand that, these kind of patients, or even with the other patients who come to the hospitals, they should get an environment which is uplifting. They should get an environment which is not just aesthetically pleasing, but it's also solving the functional problems, which means there are not maintenance issues. It's easily maintainable. It doesn't, contaminate the area. It doesn't create any kind of, doesn't support any kind of a bacteria or fungi growth. So when we said this material, and unfortunately today also, when it is being established as a product which can be used in the hospital facilities, still people question whether this is approved or not. This is approved. This is approved by American Institute of Architects, saying that it stands on 18 parameters better as compared to any other material existed till date. The second thing is that this material, the composition is ATH, which is aluminum trihydrate, which is 2/3 the mineral component, and 1/3 is acrylic, which is polymethyl methacrylate, PMMA, which is a binder. And this material has been invented by a DuPont scientist, Dr. Slocum, almost 50 years back. So this year we are celebrating the 50th year of Korian. And he had named it after his daughter's name, which is Korian. So this is how the name came. And I'm pleased today to, also share with you all our new logo, which is for the Korian design. So DuPont, you would have always seen DuPont Oval logo and Korian. But now you would see it's more of Korian design, which incorporates the whole bracket, which says, let's collaborate. Let's design new spaces. So the focus would change, and you will see it happening throughout the year now. What does it give you? If I briefly say Korian material, it gives you inconspicuous seams, which means there are no joints when you're joining the panels. It's colorful because you can choose from a color palette of almost like 200 colors globally present with us, and almost more than 100 within India. It doesn't have any kind of VOC emissions, so it's safe in the inbuilt environment. It's solid, which means it's homogeneous through and through. It doesn't delaminate. It's warm to touch and feel. Sometimes we also see this thing that there are surfaces in our room, if you touch that, you'll feel cold, which is the case with the stainless steel or any other thing. But this material has an inherent property that it will be still warmer to feel even in the cold temperatures, and in the hot temperatures still you know, easy to own hands. So it will not go as high. You know, it won't take the inherent ambient temperature. The other thing is, this is has, you know, qualifies for all kind of fire properties. So it is Euro class 1 certified. It is non-porous, non-toxic and inert, stain resistant, which is the main thing. So we have tested it against all kind of disinfectants and chemicals that we use in the hospital environment, which is, if you see this thing, I mean, on one side we show this before and after, which would mean that all these stains, we put it onto the material, and with the, you know, required kind of maintenance, we could easily clean it off. So that's a white surface. One side there are stains, the other side it has been wiped off, and the surface is again new. So it doesn't take any kind of stains because of its non-porosity. I said it, but we should have something to qualify for, which says that it is NSF approved, it is Green Guard certified, you can get the LEED accreditations for it. It's LGA certified, which means it doesn't allow any kind of bacteria or mold to grow. UL certified. So there is all kind of certifications in place. We would request anybody, if having any kind of confusion around it, we can provide those certificates and we can give those references as well. Where it can be used, I think from aesthetically starting areas from the reception lobbies, column cladding. You would see today all of the major infrastructure projects, like even the airports, they have the column cladding with Korean. The Dial International Airport, the column cladding has been done, which is now almost like 8 years, and it's still the same. You could witness it any time. I mean, it's open. So then we talk about the other areas, which are the lift lobby areas, nurse stations. So clinical, non-clinical areas, all can be done with this material, even the furniture. And many hospitals have trusted us. They have used it. I'll just share their names. Just sharing with you some of the images, which means that you can even backlit it if you see this one, last image. So you can play with the lighting as well with this material because it's translucent. No other material will give you such kind of a flexibility in terms of the functionality as well as aesthetics. Of course, this is one area, you know, which even I was concerned of. You know, if I go to any of the hospitals, I have a daughter and she's like 4 or 5 years old. And if I take her along, she'll not feel playful in the hospital. You know, she'll start feeling bored the moment she enters there because the setting itself gives a very bad experience. But if you see, if we do something of this sort, which is where the architects and the designers come in play, so the pediatric areas become very playful. You know, you can create any kind of customized stories which are appealing and, you know, which keep the mood intact, people happy and safe. We can, of course, so this is, we talked about the most critical area. You know, some people asked how you do it. This is in the OT claddings where we have executed the projects in India. And these are some of the areas wherein the people want it on the concrete structures. We have the aluminum framing done. Then we do the bison board or the cement board substrate, and the DuPont Korean is pasted over top of it, making it seamless in concept years. We also do the ceiling the same way. This is one of those photographs from there. The OTs, how they look like after they are done. Surgical scrubs and vanities. We have displayed in our booth as well a bit of a, I would say that is just a dummy, the reason being of the transportation and all that. That's there. You have the patient rooms. You can have the bed back panels, which are the most critical areas, which get more dirtier, more difficult to maintain, done in Korea. And they serve good. Lab areas, of course, it has been used. Cafeteria, because this is also FDA approved, which means it doesn't contaminate any kind of food material which comes in contact with it. Yeah. These are the partners. I have mentioned few of them. I mean, excuse me if I forgot to mention some of more people who have trusted us. We have done work at AIMS Critical Care Unit, GTP Cancer Institute, Global Hospitals, Mumbai Asian Heart, BERT, Hospital Tirupati, we did the OTs. We are working on the High Level Cancer Institute in Lucknow presently. Dr. Sancheti's, PSG Coimbatore, Medanta's, Max Hospitals. At some of the places we have mentioned clearly, it's only the furniture and wall cladding and the vanities, but in certain we have done the operation room wall cladding, which is critical to mention here. I am always prefer to keep it simple and short, because if there is any questions, you can get back to us. It would be good having interactions face to face, one to one, on any subject. Any questions, please?
thicknesses?
Yeah.
Yeah, see, generally the recommended ones for the horizontal cladding is 12 mm. For the vertical claddings, you can use 6 mm, provided the traffic area is not more. If the traffic area is more, the recommended thickness is 12 mm. See, when we see it in terms of the, I would say, the strength, we say the 6 mm strength is almost one-tenth the strength of 12 mm. So
both can be bendable, they can be...
Yeah, so there is formable and non-formable thing, but what I have spoken here, Korean is purely formable because it has got an acrylic content in it. So it can be bent and given any shape.
Herdev, I just one question. You spoke of VOC, so is it low emission or is it zero VOC?
It's almost low, and I have the data for what it qualifies at. Because in certain areas, you know, the kind of, for example, we are using disinfectants in hospitals. Some of people use UV rays. Now people are changing to it. But it's also stable with UV rays. So there isn't any problem with that. Yeah. Countertops? Yeah, we do use that.
So Herdev, I understand that this material does not let the germs come and grow there.
Yeah.
But if we compare it with silver ion, so silver ion also kills those germs.
Correct.
So if I compare these two technologies, I would say that is active, this is passive.
So my point is this way. See, you are putting something, you are adding something to the material which kills the germs. The point here is, do the bacteria have a life of their own? I mean, can they propagate and grow without getting the medium? I would say, so if there is any bacteria lying on the surface, you are cleaning the OTs after every operation, procedure. So it gets killed on its own because it doesn't allow it to grow further.
I understand that for OTs, if you're cleaning,
correct,
it'll be clean.
Correct.
But like you shared about the bed bags, right?
Yeah, bed bag panels.
So you're
and
not going to clean it every now and then. And there are certain bacteria which would stay there for like 1 week. They have a lifespan of 1 week.
Okay.
So how about them?
So my point here is that this material will not allow them, give them any kind of a medium. Of course, cleaning is necessary, which is required there. Some places you may have to use, you know, it's a choice of materials that you make. I think the designers would choose the best, what they are using presently and how they make their transition. I am not assuring something that we can come up right away, but we are working on a technology which says that it's, you know, Korean would be kind of a Teflon kind of a thing. So which means, you know, whatever you spray onto it, it would come back. It won't stay there, stick there. Yeah.
Thank
you. So that's it. I can share those details if
sure.
Excuse me. The bacteria on the surface would survive, this means?
Sorry?
The bacteria on the surface of the Korean would survive and not get killed?
That's what I'm saying. It doesn't kill it, but it doesn't give it any medium to grow. Yeah, exactly. Please.
So I'm quite surprised. You know, nobody asked him how much it costs. Yeah. So that's the normal question that generally, you know, people would ask him, that how much it costs. If that is not the problem, I think that should be good for you.
Exactly.
Yeah. All right. So, but can I call upon, you know, Dr. Asokan, please, to come and felicitate.
Thank you, Doctor.
Thank you so much.
Thanks a lot. Thank you.
Thanks, Herdev.
Thanks.